Shanyalba Kirova presents a series of discussions about the place of Kazakh culture in the global world. Meetings with prominent public figures, candid conversations, collisions of opinions, and discussions about the most important things. Hello, dear friends. Today we are visiting the queen of our museum, Gulmira Chalabayeva. Every time I talk to Gulmira Chalabayeva, I can't help thinking how lucky the Kasteyev State Museum of Arts is. She turned the museum into a landmark cultural place. I'm sure that her creative energy will only continue to spread, and I am certain that she can truly change the cultural atmosphere of the country. Hello, Gulmira.
Good afternoon.
It is not a secret that when people think about the museum, they immediately think of your name, because it is you who managed to do the impossible. It is a colossal work you are doing, posting on social media, promoting the museum's activities, evaluating our artists, sculptors, and representatives of other creative fields. The museum has become a center of cultural life, indeed. It is a great success, and it has inspired us all so much. And I always, with great pleasure, support what you are doing, as it is exactly what is supposed to be done with the museum. But nevertheless, it seems that you cannot really achieve a high level of competition here, as you don't have enough scholars and specialists in your disposition.
Once I was a founder of a private gallery, so I know how to survive in the conditions of a market economy very well, because back then I had to try very hard to survive. I think this experience of market relations has also affected and helped me to set up this modern model of museum. I didn't want it to be just a storage.
You just became 100 times more active, all those exhibitions gathering.
Because I knew my main goal. I knew how to achieve it, and all I had to do is to set certain goals for the employees. Since I have started, I have always supported and I'm still supporting the people with modern way of thinking, creative thinking, people who radiate enthusiasm, people with shining eyes, those who want to do something, who seek to bring some kind of innovation to the work of the museum, who understand that the museum cannot remain in its classic past form that was relevant.
Before?
Exactly. It was relevant 20, 30 years ago. Today, the museum has to keep up with the pace of time. It has to transform. All these archaic academic and classical forms are good, but this is not good enough for the modern world.
Apart from the fact that you are actively promoting your museum on social networks, you definitely must have done something else to actively attract new visitors to the museum's halls. They are now always full. There is always some kind of excitement, something is happening all the time, and yet you never seem to be tired. You never stop moving forward.
There is a saying, theater starts from the cloakroom. It is the same with museums. I explained to my employees that museum doesn't even start at the front door. It starts with the LED screens outside of it, with the small things. It can be heard. As one of my friends keeps saying, the organization, especially a public one, should convey the welcome message. And as a matter of fact, people immediately started noticing it. One woman even wrote on Facebook, "Oh, you know, I haven't been to the museum for a long time, and then one day I stepped on its territory and I heard music on the street. It was the LED screen with music."
They're being promoted.
Yes, indeed. You can hear the music. There are always different videos on the screen. Each temporary exhibition always has a video feature about it. Exactly. And we resumed our small academy of arts. We call it Асем Алем. We conduct lectures.
For children.
For both children and adults. In addition, we started to hold a lot of new exhibitions, and our most important goal is to stimulate new art projects. Because every new exhibition, every art project is a newsworthy event that has to be spoken about loudly.
Will Mira, such a prominent personality as yourself, I'm sure, always has this urge to embrace all things on a global scale, including bringing up our children, our young generation. And here I'm talking about your small academy, your educational lessons, meetings. It is quite serious practical work. All of this cannot be overestimated. So, please, tell us about it.
I truly believe that aesthetic education is very important. Even if in the future a person will become a chemist, physicist, mathematician, economist, a lawyer, whatever. After all, life is not limited by one's profession. Life is multifaceted. And aesthetic education is fundamental to the child's relationship with the world.
And it's a lifetime story.
Yes, it is, indeed. Love for the world, understanding of the beauty of the world, all of this is a product of aesthetic education. You have no idea what satisfaction I get, how happy I am when I see big buses in the morning.
The children.
From which children are hopping out.
Children are getting off.
And I can't help but think, oh, well done. Well done, teachers. Well done, headmaster. Well done, class teacher who gathered the kids and brought them here. As part of a small art academy, we're now introducing a new program that is especially designed for children. I won't say that it's simplified. It's an accessible program where we tell children about where art began, starting from prehistoric times and covering its further development. We're talking about styles, different trends, about the most important ones. That is, we provide the basics.
Well, that is essential.
And at the same time, if we, for example, talk about the art of Baroque, then we play Baroque music, and the lecturer explains that these composers were working in that historical period. After all, you know, we have a division in our training. Some study music.
But don't study art.
Exactly, they don't. And we do not know, for example, what artists were working during the time of Mozart. And we decided to combine this in one lesson and tell a little bit about music.
Geographical and historical conditions. What was happening in the world of arts, literature, and music? For us, it is something we take for granted, but it has never been taught like this before.
All of this should be taught together, so that children could understand these things as a whole. We want them to understand this, at least to a small extent. After all, this is very important.
Gulmira, can you please tell me? So here we live in Kazakhstan, and for the last 25 years, we have been an independent country, and we have been developing as an independent state, whereas before, we were part of the Soviet Union. So, what do we look like on the world map today?
I think that we're still at the beginning of our way, if I'm being completely frank with you. Say we have our fine art, but it's not very old. Literally, we have only started in the 20th century.
Started to paint?
Yes, it's only then that we began to explore the academic fine arts. And therefore, it's not at all surprising that our art is poorly known abroad. In the West. And for the last 2 years, for example, we have traveled to other countries with exhibitions, but this were only baby steps. And of course, we need to lead more international projects and introduce our art to the world. I can say that our musical art.
It's more represented.
Yeah, it's represented to a greater extent, and it's been in the world for quite some time. Our music is very successful in promoting and introducing our culture and our art to the world.
It's easier?
Yes, it's easier for you. You see, it's said that the most popular art is cinema.
It's cinema.
And then all the same, there are shows and concerts that gather the audience of thousands of people at a time. And that's probably how this happened. Maybe this art is more understandable to the public, to the general audience, to the political decision makers even. And therefore, it was primarily musicians and theater artists that were touring abroad. And it's great, it's wonderful.
Thank you.
You know, Гульмира, I heard that our artists aroused great interest abroad. Some of them even became commercially successful. Many works were bought in private collections.
The word many is a slight exaggeration because, after all, not so many people abroad are familiar with the fine art of Kazakhstan. For example, if you take Russian art, then yes, they have some long-established traditions. From the beginning of the 19th century, artists have been studying in Europe and Italy, in Paris. That was a common thing. And therefore, Russian avant-garde is especially popular in the West. It's in high demand among collectors.
Художники ездили на обучение в Европу, в Италию, в Париж. Это было нормально. И поэтому русские особенно.
Unfortunately, we cannot say that our Kazakh art is equally well known. Those of our artists whom we call classics, practically no one knows them abroad. They don't know Abulkhan Kastiev, they don't know Gulfairuz Ismailova, they don't know Aisha Galimbayeva. Those who we are proud of.
Не знают Костеева, не знают Исмаилову, Галимбаеву, тех, кем мы гордимся. И нам, конечно, нужно
восполнить этот пробел.
Быстро сделать.
There is a way to do it quickly, though, but this requires a tremendous breakthrough and enormous expenses, including financial ones.
В том числе финансовые.
The world is changing so fast. Advertising management is needed.
Absolutely.
Communications.
Yes, to promote arts, you need to invest a lot.
The world is changing so fast. Can we possibly keep up with it? Do you have the feeling that, nevertheless, we will break through and that we already have enough reasons to be proud? Do you possess this lively sense of patriotism? Not the one that sometimes can be imposed with some slogans and postulates, but your inner feeling. So what do you feel? Do you sense patriotism when it comes to our culture?
You know, I have never thought about this on purpose, but now, answering your question, I think I'm a patriot. A patriot of my motherland, of our culture. If there wasn't a feeling of patriotism, you and I, dear Zhenya Yahyevna, we wouldn't be able to.
To be here.
We wouldn't be here. Wouldn't come to work on weekends, wouldn't pour our souls, our hearts, our enthusiasm into the work. That wouldn't happen. And it's precisely this kind of people. They are genuine patriots, in my opinion. And there is no need to go outside with some slogans. No. With our daily, everyday work, our attitude to our calling, we show and prove our attitude to our culture.
Мы показываем и доказываем свое отношение к своей культуре.
In one of your articles, you once wrote that you regret that we do not have censorship. What did you mean by that?
Это интересный вопрос.
This is an interesting question because apparently at that particular moment I was
mad about something?
Exactly. Something back then has caused me some very strong emotions, negative emotions. The fact is that in Soviet times, when there was strict ideological censorship, many creative people seemed to feel enormous pressure because of this. Their creativity was suppressed. They were not allowed to do certain things. And in general, when the creative process is regulated, it's wrong. There is some truth to this. On the other hand, what we got with
какая-то доля истины есть в этом. С другой стороны, что мы получили с
with permissiveness?
Exactly.
И отсутствием цензуры.
And you see what happens when there is permissiveness and lack of censorship. We now have lots of different works. As a musician, you have definitely experienced this in your field. And we, as art historians and culturologists, also observe this phenomenon in fine art.
Low-grade works of art.
Yes, to put it mildly, not quite professional works. An artist, having a diploma of some kind of an art institute, starts considering himself a professional artist. But to be honest, they're not.
They're not artists.
They're not aware of their own mistakes. They don't realize that it would be better not to exhibit some of their paintings. We need to develop artistic criticism that could carry out such censorship, a cultural censorship, if you like.
Цензуру, культурную цензуру.
For this, many years must pass and a change in mentality must occur because we have not yet left the Soviet Bolshevik ideology. On the other hand, I often hear the phrase, let all the flowers bloom. There is a spectator for everyone. And if there is a room full of people who are ready to listen, if paintings are bought, then the artist is brilliant and has his own audience, his own niche. That's a very difficult question. Before, I was more critical. Now, I think I am less critical. Because I think since people listen to the artist, it means there is something in him.
This critical attitude was very big in me too. But same as yourself, I have changed my views. Probably this is the wisdom that comes over the years. When you understand that it's not always necessary to express your critical opinion.
Please, hold on.
Yes, it's not always necessary. And every time I remind myself of a good wisdom, silence is gold.
Many things happen, and people often come across something second-rate. So in order to promote genuine art, we have to come up with something really original. Draw a line that will certainly break through this load of information. Take, for example, Yerkegali Rahmadievsky, Kudasha Duman and Dairabai, two of the most popular classic symphonic poems. And there is a young guy who created their modern arrangements, stunningly beautiful. However, many of his colleagues were very conservative at first. They were like, how come? These are our sacred melodies, why change them? But I showed them this arrangement, and they are now learning it, and it sounds amazing.
This is the wrong approach. They think that they protect traditions. They think that it should never be changed.
And that the greatness will be lost if something is changed.
Yes, and that once and for all things must be preserved. No, this is the wrong approach. Nothing needs to be preserved. Defend it, yes. But at the same time, it's necessary to bring some kind of innovation, to make it interesting for the younger generation.
Thank you very much for this meeting, and I am sure we will continue this endless conversation even outside the set, because this is our daily life, this is our beliefs, this is our everything.